that, you know, I'm against improv or allowing actors to, you know, add or, you know, try different things, but it just didn't work out that way. They stayed pretty much of their own, you know, choice stuck to the script.
Mm-hmm. Mine had a few improv moments, and actually those moments are my favorite. The scene after they have sex, you know, they have like a 10 jump fight. That was completely improvised. They just did that, and I thought it was great. I was like, keep doing that in every single take, because it worked. I love it. That's actually my favorite scene in the film.
Right.
So it was mostly scripted, but, you know, if we got it in two takes or less, I would definitely have a take for doing right. Just let the actors say whatever they wanted to say.
Can you speak more about your own personal roles and what that creative process was like for you?
You know, previous films I've made have been much smaller, involved fewer people. This was a much larger production. There's a large cast. We had a fairly, you know, large crew for a short film. There was, you know, visual effects. There was special effects makeup. There was, you know, and we had a large location. We had that whole house. So, you know, this was... There is so much collaboration involved, without a doubt. You have to rely on, you know, your actors. You have to rely on your special effects, the makeup person, the special effects makeup person in my case. Your camera operators. There's so many people that you know, the production designer who was here, but she didn't actually leave. So it, you know, it's interesting. You have to eventually trust the people that you're working with, you know, and you have to communicate what you want. But ultimately, they're going to add something to it, and you have to, you know, be able to, you know, you have to be open to that give and take.
Right. My film was a student film, so it was an entirely learning experience for me. And I was very adamant about being the only student on my set, so I was absolutely the least experienced person who worked on my film, and I think that's why it turned out not looking like a student film at all. So as far as, you know, trusting your crew goes, I, you know, really had no choice, because I specifically chose people who had worked on a lot more things than I had before. But it was a really good collaborative environment. You know, sometimes we disagree, and I think it was fine, because we're very good at, you know, explaining our thought process, and, you know, it would always be like, oh, like, either she would explain herself really well, and I'd be like, oh my god, you're right, or I would explain myself really well, and she'd be like, that's true. So, it's, you know, you're not always right, and you also can't always bend to what your crew says, so, you know, it's a nice little give and take.
Yeah, it was a great collaboration. We did a lot of work to prepare in pre-production. We took a lot of inspiration from Neon Demon and just neon lighting in general, and a lot of inspiration from Agent Provocateur commercials.
Yeah, lingerie commercials.
Yeah. So our pre-production process was, you know, getting in the same headspace, having a base of the same references that we could call out on set and put into the shots, put into the storyboards.
Yeah, it was just months long of, I saw this commercial, look at it. Yeah. Or like she'd send me like screenshots from a movie, like, look, isn't this perfect?
Yeah, and then combining the horror and the comedy and the sexiness, we had a bunch of different references. The Office, maybe a bunch of things where people look at the camera, and then Agent Provocateur, and other sexy scenes, and then...
Yeah, her particular, especially, you know, she had, you know, she was, like, holding the camera for pretty much the entire shoot, because I really wanted that, you know, that almost handheld person, you know, a human holding the camera for basically every shot in the film, so it was pretty tough, and she's got those movements down, like, she's a pro at really making it look natural.
And you both mentioned, or you all mentioned that filming is a very collaborative process. How did you, and you even said that you really like student on your film, how did you
in TV and in doing location sound. So I worked with a lot of people, a lot of professionals. Our cinematographer shot Scrubs, works on Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, 30 Rock. I was thankfully able to pull from a lot of people that I work with on a daily basis. That made that part fairly easy, although it's very hard to find grips and electrics because there's so much work in the city right now that, you know, like, nobody wants to sort of do a low budget or, you know, a short film. The cast, we got a fantastic casting director, Bess Pfeiffer, and she just knew the talent in New York. She knew who was out there, and she gave us, you know, she just found some great people. So I mean, that was how we. Well, and also my mother plays the Mabel, who's in the Shiva scene. She's here, but I think she went down for a drink.
I mean, for me, fortunately, since I was a student, I had a lot of resources lent to me by my school. We have our own casting director. My school is SVA, School of Visual Arts, by the way. We had our own casting director who taught us how to use Backstage. And I actually held normal auditions through Backstage and couldn't find anyone who fit the lead role. I went back to the casting director, like, I really can't find someone for the most important role. And she suggested Nadira. She said, I almost cast her in something. She's really good. And I just looked at her headshot, and then my first, like, very shallow reaction was, no, she doesn't look like the character. And the casting director really told me to, you know, invite her to an audition and just watch her, and she was perfect. You know, so listen to casting directors. Don't judge a person by their headshot. And I met Chloe through by a producer. I was also connected with her through my school. And I remember when I first sat down with her, the first day we met, she hadn't even signed on to be my producer yet. She was just hearing about my project. And the second I told her what the story was, she said, oh, Chloe would be perfect for it. And she gave me Chloe's name and phone number immediately, you know, before she had even agreed to be my producer, because, you know, she just knew that was something Chloe would be good for. And I met Chloe, and we immediately jived.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're best friends now. So.
Did you guys meet?
Yeah, my producer introduced us, so
yeah.
The first few times we hung out was like all business, like we only talked about the film and nothing else, but yeah, now we talk about other things.
Yeah. Now we just hang out.
Yeah.
But the director's program there is actually really great, because the head of it is a commercial director, a huge commercial director that I have worked for before, and so, you know, he gives you these huge jobs, and then he's like, oh, we want to shoot some of my student films, and you're like, I will do anything for you, you're great.
Yeah, he's Bob Giraldi, he directed Beat It by Michael Jackson.
So, you know, he pulls in really great, like, the producer, Eva, I've worked with a couple times, she's amazing, and so they're student films, but they don't feel like student films.
Okay, now I'd like to open up questions.
There be a sequel for your thing?
It's actually, this is a short version of a feature film that we're raising money for. So, no, there won't be a sequel, but hopefully we will be able to shoot the full version.
Okay, so your body, why did you choose to do the POV kind of testimonial? I mean, why was that important?
I'm just like a naturally silly person. So, you know, I wanted to write a horror story, but I also wanted it to be very comedic throughout. So I guess the way I found to easily weave comedy into it was by having the character constantly addressing you. The main inspiration for that was the movie What We Do in the Shadows. Yeah, it came out, I think, maybe 3 years ago, and the moment I watched it, I thought, this is amazing, I want to do something like this.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you're a student, it's the best time to just copy other movies.
And the people looking at the camera is super funny, and it also kind of connects you with them, like, you feel like you know how they're feeling and what they're thinking. And
yeah,
so
it's supposed to be really relatable content, so,
yeah.
You know, at least, you know, if you're my age and gender, I think you feel some solidarity.
That's the Yiddish.
I've never heard that.
You were in Hollywood Comedy Fest. Yes, we were in LA at the same festival, the same short spot.
Have you used your mom in other works of yours?
No, I've been meaning to for a long time, and this was sort of the first opportunity that kind of I had a role for some elderly women, and I was like, this is gotta use. Still obviously working on the feature version of this. There's two other short scripts that I at some point have the opportunity to shoot. There's another feature that I want to write. So there's so many things that I've kind of got going on in my head, but for the most part I'd say that the focus has been this project and the feature.
I just wrote a feature script with my friend that it's really ambitious. It's called Witches from Outer Space. And I applied to a bunch of grants to get money for it, and I got one from the Maiden NY Center at IFP to adapt it into a podcast. So now I'm in this 8-week podcasting course they gave me, and I'm learning how to adapt a feature film script into a narrative fiction podcast. So that's my next project.
My next project is in about 8 hours. I have a music video shoot, and then a Discovery Channel show in a couple weeks, and then a feature in a couple months.
Nice. Well, thank you guys so much.